guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Joanna, for those of you that don't know me. And today I'm gonna be doing a lovely video with my lovely friend, Veronica. Go follow her on her Instagram. Her name is VVeronicaMateo. And we are gonna be doing a makeup tutorial today for you guys. And she's gonna be showing you what kind of makeup she uses and some tips and tricks on how to do makeup. Okay, so we're gonna get started, guys. And don't forget to like and subscribe and give it a thumbs up.
Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and prime her eyelids with the MAC Soft Ochre Pro Longwear Paint Pot. This is gonna go and be applied on her eyelid just so that we get a smooth eyelid. So go ahead and apply it all over the eye. For today's look, we're gonna use the Jaclyn Hill palette right here. And I'm gonna start off with a transition color. I'm gonna go ahead and use this color up here. It's the third one in the first row. And I'm gonna be using a blending brush. So go ahead and just dip it in, tap off the excess, and then just go ahead and put it all over her lid. And then with another blending brush, I'm gonna go ahead and dip in into this orange. This first one on the second row, and then go ahead and add it to the crease as well. Another blending brush, and I'm gonna go ahead and dip into this orangey red color right here. It is on the second row, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the fifth color here. Tap off the excess and then go ahead and add this also in the crease. And remember, a little bit goes a long way, so get a little bit of product and then just go ahead and build up on it. Like so. And then I'm going to bring this color outwards just so that she gets like a more angled looking eye here. I'm going to go ahead and clean this up so she gets a more precise look as well. So I'm gonna deepen out her outer crease right here. So I'm gonna go in with this shade right here. It is on the third row, also the fifth shadow here. So go ahead and apply this right in her outer corner and bring it outwards. Like so. And then remember, you can always go ahead and just build up. A little bit goes a long way, so go ahead and just build it up till you get the color you want, or the darkness you want. Thank you. guys always use a clean brush when doing anyone's makeup, because you don't want to have leftover product from another person's makeup and apply it on this one, because then it's not going to come out like you want it to. So always use clean brushes. Now I'm going to go ahead and clean her crease right here with the same MAC Pro Longwear in Soft Ochre. This is Soft Ochre, so you guys are wondering what products I use. This is what I use. So I'm gonna go ahead and use a flat brush, like so, and apply this on her lid. I'm gonna go in with this gold right here. It is on the second row, last shadow, and this is gonna go ahead and be applied on where I put the concealer here. So for this, you want to get a synthetic brush, something like this. You can go ahead and dip it in here, and then go ahead and close. Want to like tap it on her eye. Like so. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and dip in into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the fifth shadow on the last row. This is like a light brown, light dark, I would say. So this is what I'm gonna use on her eyebrows. So you always want to start at the very center, like right here. Okay, the very center of her eye.
Where'd you get your makeup brushes?
This brush I actually got it at the makeup school I went to. It's a TNT brush. The school I went to is called TNT Agency. It's located in Chino Hills. So if you guys were wondering, you guys could go ahead and search it up on Google or Yelp. They have good reviews, and I honestly like the classes there because they really give you a hands-on experience instead of just you seeing like
how it's done.
Also, they have good payment plans, so if you guys want to do payment plans, you guys could do payment plans or pay it all in full, however you guys want.
How much did they charge you?
They charged me $3,500, but that was with all the brushes included, all the makeup, all foundations, lashes, with a kit, like, you know, to store your makeup, and what else? They basically provide you with everything, so you don't need to go out and buy nothing. You'll be leaving from there knowing what you're doing. You just gotta keep doing it in order so you, like, you don't forget. Okay, so I always start with the bottom first to give her, so I know what shape I want. So for her, I'm just following her eyebrow, and then I'm gonna go ahead and start and do the front. I mean the top. Sorry, the front. Okay. So the same thing with this. A little bit goes a long way, and you just want to do like swiping motions, like so. so. My dose of colors, also an eyebrow brush, but I'm gonna go ahead and use the spoolie for this just so I could take out any excess. Concealer. It's the HD Studio Photogenic Concealer in CW 6.5. I'm just gonna go ahead and apply some on the back of my hand right here. And this is just gonna go ahead and give her a more clean, precise brow. With this brush, go ahead and dip a little bit and then apply it on her brow. The rest of her face. And for that, I'm gonna go ahead and use this primer. It's also from TNT. It's HD primer. It's one of my favorites. So with a spatula, go ahead and dip in. Put it behind my hand. Okay. Two little swipes. Go ahead and get a flat foundation brush like this. This is a Morphe. It doesn't have a number, so I'm not sure which one. So just go ahead and apply some and put it all over her face. This primer is gonna help even out the skin. You know, she has textured skin. It's gonna even it out, give her a more flawless foundation. So I think she's more into this color here. So go ahead and apply some on the back of your hand. Okay, like so. With one squirt is good. And get another foundation. Go ahead and dip in the foundation and then apply on her skin. This is an angled sponge. guys could see.
No.
Okay, so it's angled, it's flat. Oh, there we go.
There you
so
go.
It's flat, and then I have another flatter end here. Okay, so it's gonna. And then for concealer, I'm gonna go ahead and use the same one. Just so that we could brighten up her look a little. Look up. And I'm gonna apply here, on the bridge of her nose, over here, and here. Okay, that looks weird, but there we go. And then just go ahead and blend it all out. Under her eyes, we're going to be using the NYX Hydra Touch powder foundation, and it's a little bit white, but that's the whole point.
We'll work with it.
We'll work with what we got.
Yeah.
So with the sponge, or you can do this with the brush too, just go ahead and press on it, get some product on there. Okay. And let's go ahead and bake. Look up. This color here, and we're gonna go ahead and contour. Go ahead and go like that. Okay. So you always want to start right here from your ear down to the lips. Okay, so go ahead and you could do tapping motions or you could do swiping motions, and then just go ahead and do circular motions. Do you see that? Maybe a little bit darker. Like so. Okay. Next side. She has a small forehead, so we don't really need to contour here, but we'll just go ahead and add a little bit just so that she gets a little bit of color up here, a little bit of bronzed up. Okay, like so. And then you just want to go ahead and bring this down to the jawline. You can always do a 3, like so. of your drawing. See that highlight come through? Look at that highlight. Okay, now we're gonna go ahead and do her blush. This palette has been through a lot. It's honestly, you guys could tell it's my favorite one. So for this, I'm gonna go ahead and use this color just to bronze up a little bit more her contour. So I feel you guys can't tell. And then for this, I'm gonna go ahead and use a Morphe R14. This is for the blush. And I'm gonna go in with this pink because this, I would use it for a person that's more lighter skin. And this would be more for like dark skin. So this one will look really pretty on her. Go ahead and smile. Gonna go on the apples of her cheekbones. So for this, you guys would want to use the same colors you guys used in her crease. Okay, so we used this one here. Pencil brush, you're gonna go ahead and dip in to this shade right here that we're using the crease too. Go ahead and look up. So whatever colors you guys use on your crease, that's the colors you guys want to use at the bottom as well. Okay, and then we're gonna go ahead and do this color here to deepen it up. And then bring it out together right here. And apply mascara. This is a telescopic L'Oreal mascara. It's my favorite for the bottom lashes. So go ahead and look up. Don't. Okay, just look up, not too high. Put your head like that. Okay, these are, I got them at Walgreens. This is the brand Kiss, and the lashes are called Flirty. You always want to measure their eye first. So I'm about half cut, like 1, 2, 3, like four little hairs. Use your favorite lash glue. I prefer the Duo in dark. Gonna apply a little squirt, a little dot on the back of your hand, and then go ahead and get some on the end of the tweezer and apply it all over the lash. Just a little bit, if you guys could tell. Okay. And just go ahead and let that dry while you work on the other eye. You can call her like the Kardashians. Don't open. I'm gonna go ahead and dip into this color again. And apply that in her inner corner right here. Okay, open. Alrighty, and then what else? Oh. Her highlight. So go ahead and use this color again on a fan brush like this and go ahead and apply this right here. Like so. You see that? Get closer. You guys see that or no? Turn this way. There we go. It's all about highlight nowadays. And also on her nose here. And here. And her lips. And then so we're gonna go ahead and use what color is this? Plum. So I'm gonna go ahead and get a little bit on. Oh my god, I told you my kid broke it.
Oh, okay, so
just go ahead and get a little bit on the spatula. Apply it on my hand. Okay. And use a lip brush like this. It's also a flat brush. Small tiny one for the lips. Okay. And we're gonna go ahead and apply this on her. Thank you.
you guys, so this is the final look right here. Sorry for my wet hair, it was up. But I hope you guys like this video and give it a thumbs up. Go follow Veronica, don't forget, it's VV Veronica Mateo. So V Veronica Mateo, okay? And we already said how to spell it and everything, so go and check that out, check out her videos, and go like her video, subscribe to her in her Instagram, and motivate her to do more videos for you guys. Okay, and then so just so you know who my lovely friend is, it's Veronica. Hey. And like I said, go like her videos, go subscribe to her, and she'll make more videos for you guys. So yeah, thanks for watching. Bye guys.